2014, I left Freetown with the purpose to go to Libya, to cross the Mediterranean for Italy. I went through Guinea, Mali, Burkina Faso, Niger, and a popular place that they used to call Agadez. From Agadez, we go through the desert. I think that part is one of the largest deserts in the world, the Sahara Desert. I went through several constraints. We were 30 in number in one vehicle, in one people, 30 in number. And it took us 10 days, day and night, as we traveled across the desert to Libya in a town called Gatron. We were in Gatron at the 10th day at night, when finally we onboard a vehicle after spending 3 days in Gatron for a big city called Saba in Libya. On our way going, we spent $800 from Agadez to Gatron. From Gatron to Saba, they asked us to pay $300. After arriving at Saba, the trafficker multiplied the transport to $600. And for us, we don't have that $600. So they held us as hostage. We are kept in a confined place where they used to beat us, they give us phones to call our beloved ones back home for them to send money for them. And we try as much as we can, our beloved, they tried to get this money before they release us. We took 7 days with them before we were finally released. We find a ghetto in Saba City where different nationals from Africa are based. In that ghetto, there you will be till you have money and also have connection from these traffickers to take you to another city or Tripoli. We were there for 3 months. When finally we have money to pay our way to Tripoli. But during the 3 months in Saba, these are the constraints we go through. When you go down the street, you will find these Libyan boys, gangsters. They call them Asma boys. As these boys see, as you are a black man, they will just find way to get rid of you. They take you to their prisons they have, and they also ask you to call your family back home to send money for you, for them, so that they will use the money and free and release you. I go through that problem again in Saba. I was caught by these boys. I spent 3 weeks with them before finally my family members back home, we are able to gather $400 and they give to them for my release. They release me. When finally I was able to have the rest of the money from them, for my family, and I paid my way to Tripoli. In Tripoli, I spent a month. There was a day when we went down to the beach where this trafficker used to come with this boat and get this illegal immigrant to take them across that canal for Italy. We went there to see how they set up look like. These traffickers, most time, they onboard people at night. And they don't care. They don't want to know whether if the boat is full or not. All what they care of, if there is 200, 300, 400, 500 or 1,000 people before them, all what they know, they collect the money and they get you on board on the boat and they direct the boat to leave the beach to cross the canal for Italy. We were there after the boat was full. The boat was so full. By our eyes, we saw that we can't make this journey today because the way this trafficker have full this boat, there will be a problem. So we decide not to go on that day. When we want to leave the beach, it's just like a game. The Libyan police guard, these guys, they know most of what is going on. They are working closely, most of them are working closely with these traffickers. If you refuse to go on the boat at that night, after you guys were left back on the beach, this police, a coast guard will just come around and get rid of you guys. They will take you to their prison yard. And they will also demand money from you. They will give you food. This is a usual thing across Libya. Every town, every city, every village, this is what has been going on. They release you today, tomorrow you don't be careful, you will go in their net again. They take money again from us. We pay $200 for our release. When finally there was a day, we come down to the beach at night to finally cross. We made up our mind to finally cross. But that day, there was a Libyan Coast Guard operation. I believe that operation does not have anything to do with these traffickers. Even the traffickers don't know about that operation. So most of us were caught by this Libyan Coast Guard. They take us to their detention center in Tripoli. In that detention center, there are thousands of Africans in that detention center. Thousands of Africans. None of them don't know their fate when they will leave that detention center, whether to go back to their home or to cross the water to Italy. We are there in that detention center. In that detention center, they will lock you up by nationality. The Nigerians, they have their own. The Guineans, they will have their own cell. The Malians, I think we are the first Sierra Leonean, because they check across that detention center. There was no room for Sierra Leonean. We are the first group that was locked up there. So we are there. Each time they bring us out to give us food, we used to tell them that we have our embassy here. We have somebody representing our country here. He's a diplomat. We want them to help us, to connect us with that person, so he will pave our release. And one fateful day, an IOM worker walked into that detention center. We are out for food when I managed to talk with him. I explained to him, tell him our situation, our condition, why we are there for. He promised me that he will deliver this message to the Sierra Leone High Commission in Tripoli, which he did faithfully. And at that time, our High Commissioner was not there, he was in London. But the message was there in his office. After 2 weeks, when he arrived, they laid down that message before him. He decided to work on it straight. Come down to that detention center, try to work with IOM to see how they will release us to come back home. And after finally they end up to agree for our release, the IOM was there to fast track our release and take us to the airport in Tripoli and bring us back home in 2014. This is the brief experience I have during my journey from Italy.